Well, welcome back to WTOL 11, Your Day. And if you're feeling overwhelmed, take a deep breath right now. You may still have to shop, bake, wrap presents, and all before Christmas. So how do you keep it together when so much is going on during the holiday season? Former U.S. Marine and mental toughness expert, friend of Your Day, Eric Rittmeyer, joins us this morning. Eric, I hear you have some ideas to help us kind of manage this holiday crazy.
Crazy is the appropriate term, Ariel, right? We think every year it's, it can't get any worse than this year, right? The next year comes around, it's like, oh my goodness. Yeah, it's an insane time for everybody. You know, if you'd asked us a year ago where we'd be this year, it wouldn't have been here. So we have to get really, really good at just remaining in control of our emotions, recognizing that everybody's hypersensitive right now. A lot of times when we get put in these situations and people are saying and doing things we don't like, it's not because they're deep down trying to hurt us. It's just that they're responding to these things in the way they know how to do it. So it's all about emotional control, which is much easier said than done, unfortunately.
So much more easier said than done, especially when we get around family members or coworkers during the holidays, and maybe we have a disagreement politically, maybe there's a family disagreement, and we start to kind of feel triggered perhaps by things our family members may say, comments they make. How do we navigate that difficult balance?
Yeah, where it all starts, Ariel, is recognizing that we are emotional creatures. We're hardwired to feel first and think later. We can't stop the emotion that we feel. What we can get good at doing is controlling the emotion. So I refer to this as responding versus reacting. When something happens to us, our innate reaction is emotion-based. We're going to say and do things we probably wouldn't normally say because we're reacting, as opposed to responding, which is when we process information logically and then formulate something that's more in line, that's not going to upset everybody, that's more logic-based. Again, sounds simple to say, much, much more difficult to do, but takes lots of practice.
It's something when you recognize it, it becomes a lot more easier, or it becomes easier over time to kind of implement. And there's something you talk about a lot, which is suspending your disbeliefs. What does that mean?
Yeah, so believe it or not, like back in caveman days, we actually could have opposing points of view and still get along with each other. It did used to happen. So the issue right now is what we have to get a lot better at is I have a thought, you have a thought. They're different thoughts. I can suspend my disbeliefs to hear you out. You can suspend your disbeliefs to hear me out. At the end of the day, when we get into these conversations or confrontations, basically with what both parties are looking for is just to walk away feeling like they've been heard. We just want to feel like they were listening to us, listening with the intent to understand, not with the intent to reply. Here's a mind blower for you. Take the letters in the word listen, rearrange them. They spell silent. Think about that.
It really is kind of eye-opening to think. I know sometimes just listening to someone and being silent, as you say, hearing what they have to say and making them feel heard, sometimes it gets rid of that defense mechanism we all have where we just kind of want to react. And it makes us feel a little bit more comfortable. So at the end, we can walk away and say, hey, maybe I don't agree with you, but I hear what you're saying and I still respect you. Moving forward, you know, how do you identify your triggers in those situations when you're dealing with coworkers and family members and you're getting to those tough situations?
Yeah, we all have these triggers, Ariel. It's just like if we're on a diet, right? If we're on a diet and we're going to a party where there's gonna be lots of food, we prepare in advance. We maybe drink a lot of water, eat something, so we're not gonna go there and eat 18 tacos. Mentally, we have to go into these situations the same way, preparing ourselves. So, okay, we know that person's gonna be there. We know they're gonna say that one thing that's just gonna get at us. So if we mentally prepare for it, it's called systematic desensitization. Two of the biggest words in my language, I have no idea how to spell them. If we can systematically desensitize our brains, we're prepared for it. So when they say that thing, we now know emotions are high. I'm gonna take a step back. I'm now gonna respond logically.
Eric, you've been coaching people for quite a while now, talking about mental toughness and kind of this resiliency with our emotions. Do you have any success stories, or maybe people listening to you have come to you and said, hey, maybe I tried some of what you were talking about and I found out, wow, it actually kind of worked for me and I avoided some of this holiday stress that I normally come to expect with my family, with my coworkers and other situations like that?
Yeah, significant amounts. And here's the great thing about my topic. I'm a little biased about this, right? Because it's my topic. But mental toughness and emotional intelligence apply to every single part of our lives, at home, at work, in our relationships with strangers. As a society, unfortunately, we've received no training on this. We're taught to memorize and regurgitate. Then we get put in situations where people say and do things we don't like, and we haven't been taught any skills for how to articulate how we feel. So what do? We go to anger, we go to violence, because we don't know how to express emotion. As a society, we got to get a lot better at teaching, especially our children, 100% of your emotions are okay. It's how you respond to your emotions that are important. Let's start teaching our kids that.
Respond, not react. Eric Rutmeyer, thank you so much for joining us, and I hope you have a great non-crazy holiday season.